Get ready to match the stars. Dick Smothers. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. From Hee-Haw, Minnie Pearl. Richard Dawson. And Fanny Flay. As we play the star-studded Big Bunny Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rivers.
Okay, John, you ready to go? You're all quite ready up here. Here. You ready? Your little penguin's crawling all over you.
I know it.
Does that hurt? All right, Chuck.
Well, I'm sitting next to a nurse. I'm fine.
Oh, yes. Take my pulse.
I'd love to.
Did you take my pulse? Why? Was there one missing? Or boom,
boom, boom, boom, boom. Very sure.
All right, let's say hello to Barbara Hawkins and Marty Rouse over here.
Hi, Marty.
Here's the current champ with $8,350. And she and Marty Rouse tied the game, and now we're in the middle of a tiebreaker. He's matched two celebrities, and when we get back from this commercial, Barbara, you've got to match two to tie and three to win your sixth game. Hurry back right after this. We're ready, if you are. Let's see how this game ends. This is the tiebreaker, the final one. Barbara, this is yours. Everyone plays. The car salesman said...
Yes?
That customer is weird. He just ordered a radio, heater, air conditioner, power windows, and power brakes. He ordered everything but blank.
Isn't that cute?
Car salesman said that customer is weird. He just ordered a radio, heater, air conditioner, power windows, power brakes. He ordered everything but blank. Are you thinking about it, Barbara? Okay. Get to you in a second. Here we go. The car salesman said that customer is weird. He just ordered a radio, heater, air conditioner, power windows.
I'm sorry, Dick, but his mother...
I was just playing.
All right. But you play, sweetheart. You have to put it in before she answers because...
Oh, I didn't have it in yet.
Oh, you didn't?
No, I was just reading it.
I thought you were... Well, he did, but he took it out and threw it away. He did another one.
Did I stick it in the slot?
Yes, you did.
Okay, then I'll go with it.
Oh, okay. No, that's all right.
It's all right. As long as she hasn't given an answer, you can change your mind.
The news camera, the news reel should come.
It's okay. Perfectly okay.
But I didn't want her to answer while you were changing.
Thank you. The car salesman said that customer is weird. He just ordered a radio, heater, air conditioner, power windows, and power brakes. He ordered everything but...
The car.
Ordered everything but a car.
That's what I wanted to say.
That's what you said. Okay. That's one for her. Score is 2-1 now. Need one more to tie.
Did you explain to him why I stopped him?
Well, the thing is, you see, if you change your answer after she has given an answer, then...
That isn't fair.
No, that's not fair.
Oh, I would never do that.
No. But I saw you writing, and I figured, well, he'll be finished a second, he'll put it in the slot, and that'd be the end. So I started to read it. But, all right, here we go.
Just kidding. I thought we were going to have to stop taping all that. I said a call.
High score. 2-2. Now, one more car will win her sixth game.
Marty, I'm sorry.
And there it is. I want the rest of you. Everybody had a car. Okay, Bobby. Pleasure to meet you, sir. Good luck to Marty Rouse. Going to send you some gifts. Thanks for coming up here, Marty Rouse. Come on. Six games, Barbara. Now I have $8,450, and here it is all for you one more time. We polled a studio audience, a very high IQ bunch like these right here. Not too long ago, and we said, you write down your best answer to this. Blank shark. Now, if you match the answer that they wrote down most frequently, you get $500. You get $250 for matching their second most popular answer, and $100 for matching the third, and three of the six will help.
Richard.
Killer. Killer shark.
Killer shark, okay.
Brett.
Lone shark.
Lone shark.
Charles.
Oh!
Card shark.
Card shark, lone shark, and killer shark are the three. Barbara, make up a mind now whether you want one of those three or want to give us one of your own.
I will say lone shark.
Lone shark is what she wants? All right, lone shark is the one that Brett gave you. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where? Let's begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 response.
Killer shark is Richard's answer. All right, that's up there. Let's see if we get a loan shark under the $250 response. Great white shark. Don't look too good for you, honey. But don't give up yet. All right, let's go up to the top and reveal the big one. You got it.
Very good.
Now you pick up another $500. You're very close to $9,000. You got $89.50. Now you could win $5,000 right here. If you match one celebrity exactly.
Richard.
Okay, here we go. Stand on the blue dot there. And this is it. Good luck to you, Barbara. It's worth $5,000. It reads as follows. Blank lamp. L-A-M-P. Blank lamp. All right, Barbara, now you have to give us the answer that he's written down on that card. And if you do, we give you an additional $5,000.
Sun.
Sun lamp. All right, Richard. He says sun lamp will match you for $5,000. What do you say to that?
I said oil.
Oil lamp. Oil lamp. Yeah, that's a good one there. Well, they're both kind of good there. Okay, Barbara, you're going to meet another player a little bit later. Right now, we want America to watch this message or two. Now, would you all join me in welcoming a couple here named Linda Duggan? Hey. All right, Linda. When?
October.
October. Oh, here it is September already,
that's
isn't
Scorpio.
It?
Scorpio.
That's next month, right.
Right.
Okay. Where are you from?
San Diego.
Yeah.
My husband's a Navy helicopter pilot.
He is.
And we have a little girl. She's 3 years old.
Right. You get a chance to watch his show a lot with a little girl running around the house?
That and
keeps
Sesame
you busy?
Street.
Yeah. That and Sesame Street. Okay. Anything else you want to say about yourself?
No, thanks.
Okay. Good luck to you there, here. Good luck in San Diego and your blessed event. A or B, Linda?
B.
All right. B for baby. Now I want to tell you how dull Sydney is. His favorite comedian is blank. That's how dull Sydney is. Let me tell you how dull Sydney is. His favorite comedian is blank. Rimbaugh.
His favorite comedian
no.
is...
No.
I'll tell you how dull Sydney is. His favorite comedian is blank.
Is there going to be one right answer for this? Or...
No, there could be several.
There could be several. Does Linda have... Do you have a preference?
Shh. No, no communications with the contestants, if you please.
Oh, I was just going to see what kind of a child she wanted. Was she wanted male or female?
Oh, boy or girl. There, boy.
Yeah, I wasn't going to ask you about questions or anything.
Well, that's terrific. You have to figure out how to spell it.
Boy, he really didn't know me.
All right. No, it's in there. Okay.
That'll be a question for next week.
All right, Linda, you ready? Linda, I want to tell you how dull Sydney is. His favorite comedian is?
Jimmy Carter.
Oh. It was in. What'd you say?
Jimmy Carter.
Jimmy Carter. All right, she said Jimmy Carter.
Carter or
Cutter?
Carter. That's a
Billy
Carter.
She didn't
Jimmy
say,
Carter.
She didn't say. Oh, I said Walter Cronkite.
Walter Cronkite. Okay, Brett, that's a good one.
I went for one of our faves, Howard Cosell.
Howard Cosell. That may be the definitive one.
Yes.
Howard Cosell.
Now you got two of those. You got the idea, Linda. Now you're catching on. You watch his program. You know we've poke a little fun at Howard Cosell. Friendly fun, of course. We're all so fond of him. Yeah, hello, Minnie. You know who Howard Cosell is?
Yes.
Yes. Uh-huh. Did you write Howard Cosell?
No.
What did you write?
I wrote me.
You wrote you. Minnie Pearl. Tell me how dull Sydney is. His favorite comedian is Minnie Pearl. Well, I think you're kind of amusing myself.
You're nice.
Yes, I do.
Howard Cosell.
Howard Cosell. And?
Oh, he's a popular favorite.
Yes, indeed he is. All right, so... If you had said Howard Cosell, you'd be in clover right now, wouldn't she, Barbara? All right, this one is yours. The fried chicken chef said to the psychiatrist.
Uh-oh.
Yes?
Doc, it used to be I was attracted to birds. Now it's everything with feathers. Yesterday I tried to deep fry a blank. The fried chicken chef said to the psychiatrist, Doc, it used to be I was attracted to birds.
No.
All right.
Speak to Charles, Jean. Come on, hon.
Now it's, I was attracted to birds. Now it's everything with feathers. Everything with feathers.
Feathers is the
Yesterday I tried to deep fry a blank.
I got it.
You got it. You don't have it?
No,
Fried chicken chef said of the psychiatrist's doc, it used to be I was attracted to birds. Now it's everything with feathers. Yesterday I tried to deep fry a... I thought this would be so easy.
No, my mind is going blank.
Well, you got to say something now before the buzzer sounds.
A hat.
Okay, yesterday I tried to deep fry a hat. She drew a blank and said something.
I said a fan dancer.
A fan dancer.
You know that.
Anything involving, you
Gypsy
know, feathers.
Gypsy Rose Lee had
they
those.
They use feathers. That's right. Ostrich feathers is what she used.
I said a feather duster.
Feather duster is a good one. Charles?
You're not going to like this, but...
Indian!
An Indian. Anything with feathers is what we're looking for.
Feather duster.
Feather duster. Okay.
A pillow.
Pillows. Good one.
Of course.
What do you say, Fanny?
I don't know what... I know what I was trying to say, but I didn't. I was trying to say a Zsa Zsa Gabor outfit.
A Zsa Zsa outfit.
Right.
Or...
No,
yesterday I tried to deep fry
feathers.
A Kitty Carlisle.
There.
All right. So there you are, round one. Now we go to round two. Linda, you may have A or B.
B, please.
B it is. Mildred said, my husband, the doctor, treats me like one of his patients. All he ever says to me is blank. My husband, the doctor, treats me like one of his patients. All he ever says to me is blank. All right, everybody's busy writing over there.
Busy,
busy, busy.
It's okay, hon. The majority of my work is done. Go ahead.
All ready? Mildred said, my husband, the doctor, treats me like one of his patients. All he ever says to me is blank.
Take off your clothes.
You got the idea, Linda. Take it off.
That's what I said. You may disrobe.
You may disrobe now. There's one for Linda. Okay.
I'm trying to think when was the last time somebody asked me to take off my clothes.
Shh.
Oh, yes, it was the doctor. Take off your clothes and hurry up. There are other patients waiting.
Okay. To match anyway.
Take your clothes off and the baby is due in October.
Okay. All right. Now, what'd you say, Minnie?
Take your clothes off.
Okay. You got four, Linda. Naturally, Richard will ask you to take off your clothes.
In medical terms, strip.
Oh, yeah. Doctors do say that. Fanny, don't let her down. She's fragrant.
Oh, no. Well, you know, I thought that they always say to me, when are you going to pay the bill? They're so hostile.
Really? All right. So now you've picked up five, and you've got a little work set for you, but right now we've got this for you. Okay, Barbara, you want A or B? A. Okay, fine. Thank you very much. Here we go. Count Dracula said,
Judy is an old-fashioned girl. On our first date, she wouldn't let me bite her neck. The only thing she'd let me bite was her blank.
She wouldn't let me bite her neck on the first date. The only thing she'd let me bite was her blank. Okay? Right. Good one. Splendid. Write it down there. Write it down. Write it down.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Now, Barbara, Count Dracula said, Judy is an old-fashioned girl. On her first date, she wouldn't let me bite her neck. The only thing she'd let me bite was her blank.
The operative word is old-fashioned, right?
Old-fashioned girl.
Her hand.
Her what?
Her hand.
Her hand. Bite my hand. What do you say?
My hand.
Hand, a one for you. Score is 5-1. Brett?
Do I have to be a match? Is this it?
No, 5-1 is a score.
Oh, okay.
Put your glasses on, Brett.
What?
Come to the party.
I said toenails.
Toenails. Gotta match everybody to stay in the game now, Barbara. Charles?
Fingernails.
Fingernails, that means Linda Barton wins the game on the rest of the game. Here. I'm going to say goodbye to this lady who's leaving here with a bundle, $8,950. Great to see you. You could go all the way and get $5,000 here. Let's see how it goes. Not too long ago, we got a bunch of people in here and we said, write down your best answer to this. Victor blank. Now, if you match the answer they gave us most often, you get $500. For matching their second most popular answer, you get $250. And then for matching the third, you get $100. And three of the six are allowed to help.
Richard.
Victor Mature.
Victor Mature is one.
Charles.
What are you going, Victor?
I've got that. That's good.
This is a good one. Well, they're all so boring. Victor Herbert.
Okay.
Fanny.
Victor! No.
Wait, geez.
Is something coming from above?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yes. Well, I don't know.
Victor, well, okay, Victor Borga. Yeah.
Victor Borga.
They're all like...
Borga. Okay. So there it is. Borga, Herbert, and Mature are the three. Do you want one of those, or have you got a better idea?
I'll take Victor Borga.
You'll take Victor Borga. Okay. Let's see if Victor Borga is up there. May we see the $100 response? Borga it is right off the bat. Better than nothing, isn't it? Let's see what's up there under the $250 number. Victor Mature is Richard's answer. What do you think's under the big one?
Hugo.
Victor Moan and Victor Hugo. All right, slide it. Hugo. I told you it was a better than average IQ bunch out there in that audience. They're very good. Listen, you've won 100. You're going to play for 10 times that amount or $1,000. Now you got to match one celebrity to collect.
Richard.
Here we go. Both of you stand right there in the dark. Don't talk until I tell you to. Okay, here we go. All right. Ready? Good luck to you. Get your ESP flowing over to Richard. Blank hospital. Blank hospital. Linda, you think about it. And give us the answer that matches his now.
Maternity.
Maternity hospital. Didn't hear you. Speak up.
Gonna be a mother.
That's right. All right, let's find out what Richard said. Richard.
This is on every day, I thought. General Hospital.
General Hospital. Good soap opera, right. Yeah.
They have a lot of them in there. Yeah. Now.
You do forgive them, don't you? Okay, all is forgiven. Linda, you've got a total of $200, and you are still the champ. You will meet another player. So let's welcome Doris Haddock. Bring her out here. Hello, Doris.
Hello.
You know Linda?
Yes, thank you.
Now, Doris, we'd like to find out a little bit about you, if you please.
Yes. Mother of five, grandmother for the first time, avid bowler, carry a 181 average.
Really? That is pretty good. Very good for you. All right, we can't start this game right now. We have some other business we have to attend to, but we welcome you and wish you well, and right now we've got this for you. Listen, some nice fellow in the audience down there said you gave his pacemaker a charge. Would you do something for him, the characteristic thing that Minnie Pearl does?
Well, I wish I could go down there and shake hands with him because his wife might be with him. But I do appreciate his
You could holler at him a little bit, though.
Howdy!
Sure you could. Right. Okay. Team Radio, join us next time. We're Matt James. 77. Bye.